Good morning, dear friends. Once again, welcome in the physics lecture. Once again, students, we will start with our topic, subtopic, electric flux.
So, last time also, I have given you a huge idea about electric flux. So, first, let us start with a good revision of electric flux.
Yesterday, whatever the cases we have studied. So, first we will take the revision of that. And after that, we will try to solve some problems on electric flux and also charge density. I hope you are studying the module. So, always try to solve the problems in module also, because that's also very important. So, as told you yesterday,
electric flux is the number of field lines passing through given area. Number of field lines crossing the given area.
So, you may be thinking that why, sir, you are repeatedly telling these stories of electric flux, because as you are about to start with the Gauss theorem, so but for Gauss theorem, that is the very very precious theorem, very very important theorem in electrostatics. So by applying the Gauss theorem, we can find out electric field for any closed surface. So in that, electric flux is important. So last lecture what happened? I have explained it, but I think again there should be some brush up with this electric flux, and then we'll go for problems of that.
So as a number of field lines crossing the given area.
So what it means that we have already studied yesterday, this last lecture.
So suppose this is the electric field, and I do have, suppose, one square plate which is like this. This is a square plate.
In 3D you can see that, like that it is. If it is the electric field, that will be like this. So, beta,
this will be my electric field, vector E. This is the area. So, I will try to draw
the area vector for that. So, what will be the area vector? Area vector,
as I told you last lecture also, area vector, I have explained everything.
L cross B, B cross L. So, that already I explained. So, beta, area vector means
vector perpendicular to area. A vector which is perpendicular to given area. So, here if I will go for area vector, this is what? Vector A.
So, you have to find out
what is the angle made by electric field with the area vector, that is theta. And you are knowing that, of course.
What are we going for?
We are going for the dot product of
electric field and area vector,
that you are knowing. So electric flux in this case will be phi E is equal to vector E dot vector A. In the sense, phi E equals vector E into magnitude E into vector A into cos of the angle between them. And then we have studied the cases. Suppose theta is 0, means your area is perfectly perpendicular to electric field, so that area vector will be
parallel to electric field.
Electric field perpendicular to area. What it means, area vector will be parallel to electric field. So this is electric field this is area vector, theta will be 0, so cos 0 1, cos 0 1, and we will get phi e to be just e a, and this is called as maximum value of flux.
Maximum.
If it is antiparallel, it means if I am considering the back side of that, this surface, so this will be my area vector. And suppose electric field is like that, then better that will be theta equals pi.
If theta is equal to pi, then what will happen in that?
Theta will be pi, and cos theta will be minus 1.
Cos theta will be minus 1.
And then phi e will be equal to minus e a. So this is the minimum value. Actually, I have repeatedly told you, the cos function and sine function, they will move with minus 1 less than or equal to sine theta less than or equal to 1. Minus 1 less than or equal to cos theta less than or equal to 1. So that you have to remember. So I am going to have a look over this also, because
that is very much important task for you to understand. Sine and cos function both
vary between 1 and minus 1. No? Then suppose this is my sine function, so that topmost value will be plus 1 and bottommost value will be minus 1. The same way, cos function, of course, it will vary not in the same way like this, but here also maximum value is plus 1, minimum value is minus. So this is for sine theta, this is for cos theta. That you have to know.
So yesterday, actually, I wanted to. Last day I wanted to explain all the cases, so I have not explained much more about this all. That's why I am just giving the overview. So this you have to keep in mind. Of course, this is for those who still don't know about this function and how they vary. I hope everybody will be knowing that, but I find it's my responsibility to share with you. Okay, that's all.
And now last thing, suppose if the if you want to note down, you may pause the video and note it down. Okay, shall I move further? Now what will happen is that if I will take theta to be pi by 2, if theta I will take pi by 2,
then let me know what will happen.
So you may just turn your pages of notebook,
you will get to know what will happen.
Okay. So if theta is pi by 2, this area vector will be like this and electric field will be like this. So suppose my area is parallel to electric field. This is my area. This is my area and this is my area vector. Okay, and this is electric field. This is my area. This is electric field and this is area vector. Now theta is pi by 2 or 90. So of course cos theta will be 0. So this surface will not have any flux.
This surface will not have any flux. So the summary of the discussion is that in order to take the flux passing from the surface, okay, maximum flux will be for the surface which has area vector parallel to the electric field. Okay, minimum value, area vector antiparallel to electric field, and zero flux, area vector perpendicular to the electric field. So at least try to focus on either. If you are thinking about area, then what we can do? Area perpendicular to electric field. Then of course, as area vector is perpendicular to area, so perpendicular means it will be parallel to electric field. So don't mix that. Go with either scenario. Both are same. So whatever you want to keep in mind, the way in which that you that way you may go with. Okay, so either you can think like that area
perpendicular to electric field,
area again perpendicular to electric field. So यहाँ पे आपको problem है क्या? यहाँ पे both area is perpendicular to electric field, but here the area vector is parallel and here area vector is antiparallel. That is why I told you in the form of area vector. So that will be most convenient for you if you will keep in mind about area vector. So I think it's understood to you. You may note down that actually it has been already shared with you. So no need to note down. Okay. Now, we shall try to solve some problems regarding to flux. Okay, that means suppose let me start with simple problems. Problem number 1.
That also I will try.
There is a cube.
Newton per coulomb, I have. So it will be 18
newton per coulomb. In this way, of course, 18 newton per coulomb. In this way, as here also 18 newton per coulomb. So first of all, let me get the area vector. Okay, where will be the area vector that I actually must know? So beta, here if you go for area vector, then what you do is this will be my area vector. This will be my area vector. Now case one, if you go for case one, if you go for here, electric field is in the x direction, right? So E is equal to 18 newton per coulomb, and area vector also like that. Area vector will have same magnitude as that of the area, and direction is given. So area is given 3 centimeter length in the side. So area will be 3 into 3, that is 9 centimeter square. Centimeter to meter, 9 into 10 to the minus 4 meter square. So and theta will be 0. So cos 0 will be 1. So what I can get it? I can get from this that y e will be e dot a magnitude of a cos of the angle between there. Get it, my point?
Okay.
Magnitude of E is 18 multiplied by magnitude of A is 9 into 10 to the minus 4. Everything will be newton meter square per coulomb. 162 into 10 to the minus 4. You can also write 0.0162 newton meter square. Cool. So these are the flux passing through this side of the cube. Okay. I suggest you to again watch that by pausing or rewinding the video, so that you will get to know how I have done that. Very slowly I have shown you. Now we'll go for next two cases. So beta, for next two cases, what will happen? That we'll see. This one is over, okay, about x, along x, that's over. What to do about for along y and for along z? That means along y it will go for, that will be 18 newton per coulomb. 18 newton per coulomb, but we must know that, say it is case 2, electric field vector and area vector are perpendicular to each other, because electric field vector is in this direction and area vector is in this direction. So they are perpendicular to each other. Of course, theta pi by 2, cos theta come out to be 0. No need to calculate, directly convert, electric field will be 0. Same way for z also, z is like that, no? And this is your area. So like this, you can say. They both are again perpendicular to each other. So case 3 also, no need to calculate. Why I am showing this? Because in many problems, big problem means big explanation they are giving. Student think that abhi nahi ho jayega. Abhi to clean bold hai. रीड ही नहीं करते प्रॉब्लम, ठीक से रीड किया तो उसमें दिए डायरेक्टली नहीं दिया रहता, लेकिन कुछ तो हिंट दिया रहता है कि हाँ बाबा ये दोनों परपेंडिकुलर है. दैट इज द थिंग. इफ दे आर परपेंडिकुलर, नो नीड टू कैलकुलेट. सो एक्चुअली इट सेव्स योर टाइम. डायरेक्टली यू कैन राइट फाइ बी जीरो. सो समरी ऑफ द डिस्कशन, if I keep this cube in the electric field, which is along x axis, then of course I am getting maximum flux. But if it is kept in the electric field, which is along y axis, then for this phase there will not be any flux. Z axis, same, there will not be any flux. Means, what I mean to say, here for each phase there are 6 phases for the cube. Okay, so for each phase, depending on the area vector, we can decide for the given electric field, will there any flux or not. Okay, so that we can decide. So this is a basic one. You will get plenty of problems in your module regarding to problems like this. So I will suggest you to solve this. This means practice this and solve the different type of problems. Okay, so we will go for the next one. So beta, as a flux is concerned, there are plenty of problems you can make. Okay. Sometimes they mix with Gauss-Hart condition and flux. So that depends. But as flux is considered, you must be knowing. Okay. So as a second problem, now we will take the problem which is without diagram. Diagram, you are supposed to do that diagram, or directly also you can do. Okay. So that type of problem also you will practice. Okay. So the problem is, see the board. The problem is, see problem number 2. A surface has area vector A equals 2i cap plus 3j cap meter square. The definition of flux.
So directly can do that. There is no problem. That's not a big task. Phi E equals vector E dot vector A. Vector E is I plus J dot vector A is 2i plus 3j. Okay.
So directly do the multiplication. 1 multiplied by 2 plus 1 multiplied by 3. 2 ones are 2 plus 3 ones are 3. It will be 5 newton meter square per coulomb. That will be the electric flux passing through this area. Okay. So that was about the
practice problem for flux. That was the second time.
Okay. So for your practice,
actually it is a practice of dot product. No need to be worried about that.
Okay.
I will give you homework. Vector A
directly. I will give you values, given values, and you calculate the number.
Vector A is I cap minus j cap plus k cap meter square. Electric field 2 I cap plus j cap newton per coulomb. Phi E question mark.
This is the homework one for today.
Homework one. Now homework two.
Homework two.
Flux is given 10 newton per coulomb. Area is given I cap plus j cap, and they are asking electric field is how much. You can do that.
You can do that.
Okay, so like this problem one we will solve. It's very simple, like we solved the problem from scalar product last year. 11. The same way we will solve it. Okay. So that's not a big task. Homework 3.
Homework 3 will be
flux is 2 newton meter square per coulomb. Electric field is given I cap plus 2 j cap newton per coulomb. They are asking what is the area. Area means what is the area vector. So that you. So I suggest you notice down 3 homeworks. I am expecting the answers of these 3 homeworks from you. Of course.
Actually, it is expected that you should send the copy of the given homework and the notes to your subject teacher. I don't know for other subjects you are sending or not, but for physics you are not sending the copies of homework. So dear friends, keep in mind, whatever is your internal assessment is there. Okay, internal assessment, it has some marks for practical, your journals, your project, whatever. So beta, right now as you are in home, for your internal assessment to send the copy of all the work whatever is told by your subject teacher is very important. On that basis we will assess you internally, what study you are doing, how much study you are doing, are you present for Google Meet. We have kept the marks for that. Okay, and unfortunately many of you have not got a single mark for last some days from where we started. I think from 26-27 somewhere we started, and yet many students have got not a single mark for that, because they have not sent me any photograph of the notes. Okay, they have not asked any doubt. Okay, if you are not having any doubt, at least you may just send me the message, sir, today I read NCERT page number this to this, or today I watch your lecture and I have understood everything. Some students are sending the message, some students are coming for Google Meet also. Okay, and this also, those who will watch this video till end, they will get to know what sir told. So just aapko bol ke rakha hai ki internal matlab hamara kuch marking hai har ek student to chal raha hai, aage chal raha hai. To jaise jaise aap kaam karoge wo marking system band ka jayega. To baad mein aap ye nahi keh sakte ki sir ye aisa kya bol rahe hain, aap internal mein hame हमने क्या नहीं किया, तो क्या नहीं किया, तो ये ही नहीं किया। आप सोच रहे होंगे घर में बैठा हूँ, नहीं, इट इज़ नॉट लाइक दैट। स्कूल इज गोइंग ऑन ओनली ऑनलाइन ड्यू टू द कंडीशंस, सो ट्राई टू थिंक लाइक दैट। हाँ, होल डे वी आर टेकिंग एफर्ट्स फॉर यू पीपल, मीन्स दैट्स अवर ड्यूटी। मैं कुछ क्या बोल रहा हूँ, कुछ अलग नहीं कर रहा हूँ, आई नो दैट इट्स माई ड्यूटी, बट अगर आपके लिए टीचर इतना दिन भर कर रहे हैं, नॉट ओनली मी ऑल द टीचर्स, तो आपका रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी बनता है कि गूगल मीट को प्रेजेंट रहना है। हाँ, पाँच छः बच्चे आज ये आए हैं, परसों वो आया, सो इट शुड नॉट हैपन। आई डोंट नो वाई यू आर रिमेनिंग एबसेंट, लेकिन एक बात बता के रखता हूँ, once you will enter the school and anybody out of you will insist for explaining this everything, I will explain, there is no problem. It means that you will be going back. So now decision is yours. Those who will watch the lectures regularly, with a good concentration, those who will make their notes regularly, those will be present for doubt sessions regularly, they and they only will be at the top of the rankings. If anybody will ask, you will suggest many things, this must be good, this quality must be good, this must be, I know that, okay, it must be there, but with that we are also expecting from you, and many of you are not up to the mark, so don't take it otherwise. As your physics teacher, I thought it's very important to share with you this one thing. So abhi tak jinhone theek se kaam chalu nahi kiya hai, okay, unko kaam karna chahiye, kyunki क्या होता है, बी ऑनेस्ट विथ योर सेल्फ। आज आपको ऐसा लगेगा, अरे ऐसे मराठी सर को ये किया, फंसा है, बहुत हो गया, कुछ नहीं किया, खाली गूगल मीट को ऑन करके कैमरा बंद किया, साउंड बंद किया, सो गया। मराठी सर 10 मिनट मेरा नाम कह रहे थे, जाने दो क्या है, देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम, आई विल टेक योर नेम वंस ट्वाइस थ्राइस 3 days, 4 days, over the period, I will also neglect you. Okay. Every action has equal and opposite reaction. जो टीचर के साथ में कॉन्टैक्ट में रहेगा उसका फायदा होगा, टीचर उसी को आंसर पूछेगा, टीचर उसी को जवाब दे देगा। दिस इज द नेचर्स रूल एंड वी ऑल्सो फॉलो दैट, ओके, सो वी सीरियस अबाउट दिस पॉइंट, ओके। Let's go for this. Before that, I will suggest that write down the homework. Okay, pause the video. Write down. Okay, shall I go? Okay. So now, one of the important things which are necessary for you people, those are. We can categorize. First is, so I will go for how to practice, because now the last session only is remaining, that is Gauss law, and I don't want to go fast as you may be lagging behind otherwise. So one by one we will go. Gauss theorem within one or two lectures I can finish. There are some applications, cases and problems regarding to the Gauss theorem. There is nothing special. Now, how to practice? So, make 4 parts. One part, Coulomb's law. In between, both are important.
Coulomb's law. Applications. Applications मतलब क्या? Problems. Problems on Coulomb's law. Okay, ये आपको करना है. Okay. Second चीज. Coulomb's law after that. You will also go for charging process. Actually, it is before charging methods, properties of charge, charging methods, friction, conduction, induction. Problems may come on that. Properties of charge, quantization, additivity, conservation. So, the problems may be theoretical type, problems may be numerical source. Here, mostly problem will be of numerical type. Here, problem will be of, maybe of theoretical type, theoretical.
ये प्लास्टिक का ये बन गया, इसका ये बन गया, कैट्स बन गया, तो क्या पॉजिटिव चार्ज करेगा या नेगेटिव चार्ज करेगा, व्हाट एवर दैट विल कम फ्रॉम देयर.
थर्ड थिंग व्हिच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नो अंडरस्टैंड इज अबाउट जस्ट द डेंसिटीज. ओके, चार्ज डेंसिटी. सो बेटा चार्ज डेंसिटी इज वेरी वेरी important. Okay, so lambda, sigma and rho, they all will have problems. Of course, problems with numericals, and they will be useful next in the Gauss law, whatever will be about to start. So in the Gauss law you will need this charge density. Understood? So you have to solve that. And last one that we have studied right now, that is electric flux. What it is? Electric flux. Also numericals. So I think you must be ready with at least 20 numericals to be solved. Coulomb's law its application, 10 to 15 numericals to be solved, or all numericals, also not numericals, all the MCQs. MCQ will be there in your body, so you will go for it. And charge density at least 20, and electric plus at least 20. So there will be a database of 20 plus 20 plus 10 plus 20. 23 is a 60 plus 10. At least 70 problems, and of course I know that in your module 70 plus problem will be there. So I hope you go for the problem. Right now last 3-4 lectures continuously I am solving problems also with this. So now there is no problem. Again after the completion of this topic, of course I will be keeping some problem solving sessions which will contain some specific type of problems. That's all that I know. That is an important task that you need. So that I will do. So this is overall scenario, and if you do that, then at least you will have a chance to say that I know electrostatics some part. Okay. Because as you go ahead, then the syllabus will be becoming vast and vast. Okay, not like that. Some 4 definitions I will recite, 2-3 derivations I will practice, and I will be facing the exam. No, not like that. You have to do a lot of practice because the competition is big, as your GC, CET, everything, exams are concerned. Then you have to be part of the competition. So if you want a success, then do it. Otherwise, it's okay. Your luck and your future. Okay. That's all. We'll go for now.
very important theorem in electrostatics, that is called as the Gauss theorem. So what we do today, we will have a deep introduction of the Gauss theorem, how it can be stated, what is its use, and how it may be applied for different surfaces. So its applications, we will go to understand them in the next lectures, but today at least we will try to complete Gauss theorem. The statement is, first of all, I will show you the mathematical statement so that it will be easy for you to make the statement of the Gauss theorem. Otherwise, there is a popular statement of the Gauss theorem that read sakte ho, lekin usme kuch fayda nahi, directly dekhne se aapko statement samajh aayega. Suppose फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डायग्राम देखा था, उसके बाद में स्टेटमेंट, उसके बाद में स्टेटमेंट मतलब मैथमेटिकल, उसके बाद में हम बनाएंगे. ओके, आर यू रेडी फॉर दिस?
दिस इज एनी क्लोज सरफेस, एनी क्लोज सरफेस, सरफेस मस्ट बी क्लोज,
मींस इट विल हैव इट्स ओन बाउंड्रीज, शोन लाइक दिस. ओके,
closed surface.
Any closed surface. Shape doesn't matter.
Any shape. Any shape.
There is no problem. Shape, whatever it may be. It may be geometrically, means perfect, having perfect geometry, not having perfect geometry, no problem. No to worry. Okay.
Any closed surface, any shape. Okay. So first of all, I will write on here. I will not get any closed surface. That is first one. Second, what I told?
Yeah,
it is any shape. Third one,
any number of charges. आपको जितना लेना है उतना ले, ऐसा कुछ नहीं, इतना ही चार्ज होना चाहिए, ऐसा कुछ नहीं.
एनी नंबर ऑफ चार्जेस एट एनी पोजीशन, मतलब इसके अंदर चार्ज होगा
तो ऑफकोर्स उसका मिला के वो अपना इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड करेंगे ना मैडम. ओके, like that also
you may
get the idea.
So like that surface we have considered, any closed surface we have considered.
First of all, I'll make it closed.
Okay, and suppose this is the electric.
Okay. Okay.
So actually, Gauss law tells that while total
file total means what? Total electric field.
Okay, what it is?
Total electric field.
Sorry, total electric flux, not field. Total electric flux.
मतलब इस सरफेस से कितना इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स जाए उसका टोटल फ्लक्स विल बी इक्वल टू
qENC upon epsilon naught.
qENC का मतलब इट्स वेरी सिंपल,
qENC मतलब टोटल चार्ज एनक्लोज्ड, टोटल चार्ज एनक्लोज्ड बाय द सरफेस.
सो दिस आर द रिक्वायरमेंट्स. टेक अ क्लोज सरफेस एनी शेप, हाँ, टेक एनी नंबर ऑफ चार्जेस एज पर योर कंसिडरेशन. At any place you may consider them to be situated with, that is not a problem. Now if you want to calculate the total flux,
that will be, total flux will be total charge enclosed divided by epsilon naught,
where epsilon naught is called as the permittivity of the medium. Once we will go for dielectrics, polarization, in that we will go to understand this, what is epsilon naught, what is epsilon r, relative permittivity, and what is absolute permittivity. So right now I will not discuss that, and its value also afterwards we will discuss 8.4 into 10 raised to and that those values and all that we will explain in the next topic when we will go for dielectrics and polarization. So for right now, we must know this phi total, that is the total electric flux. Okay, talk about of this surface.
Electric field,
right now I have not shown.
Okay,
so this is the scenario.
Okay,
so what can be the statement for Gauss theorem? Okay, for a closed surface of any shape, for a closed surface of any shape, the total electric flux coming out of the surface is equal to total charge enclosed divided by permittivity of the medium. It is simple cause.
Okay. So for a given closed surface, I will try to make the statement of that. For a given closed surface, the total electric flux over the surface is equal to qENC, total charge upon epsilon naught, where qENC means, just I told
qENC what it means, total charge enclosed by the surface.
Total charge enclosed by the surface.
That's all. Understood.
Okay.
So, for that, I will take this as my Gaussian surface. Sorry, this as my surface, not Gaussian surface.
This is my surface. And suppose this is the direction of electric field. Okay. So according to Gauss law, what it will become? According to Gauss law, just now I explained that according to Gauss law, what I can write? I can write phi E will be equal to Q enclosed upon epsilon.
Okay.
That is my equation number 1.
Now we are knowing the definition of flux in the form of electric field, area, getting it. So what I will do? I In order to get in that way, I can suppose one small element.
Okay.
One small element.
Okay. Of area BA. But instead of taking BA
area,
I'll take the area vector to be B. Okay.
Now electric field you are going. Electric field.
I have shown you. So suppose this is the electric field. So I can write this to be E and this to be vector
D. So of course the angle between E and D,
what would be the angle between E and D? This would be theta. So I consider a small element DA, small area element DA.
And then I will calculate it. So first
we will consider small area element.
First, we will consider the small area element
dA and we will try to calculate flux through it. ये ऑनलाइन चल रहा है इसके लिए सब लिख के भी दे रहा हूँ क्योंकि वहां पे मैं साथ साथ बोल सकता हूँ, आप इसको नोट डाउन करो मेरे साथ साथ। तो वैसे ही ये ऑनलाइन में आपको लिख के देता हूँ, ऑफलाइन में बार बार आपको इधर से उधर से ऐसा उठा के समझा क्या समझा क्या ऐसा करके मैं बोल सकता हूँ, अभी नहीं कर पा रहा हूँ। तो थोड़ा स्पीड कम करके ये सब आपको लिख के दे रहा हूँ, मतलब आपको भी ऐसा लगे कि बाबा सर अपने साथ है अभी और उन्होंने ये बताया। तो ये आपको डेरिवेशन में लिखने का जरूरत नहीं है, लेकिन आपको मालूम होना चाहिए हमने क्या किया। फॉर दैट सेक आई हैव शोन दिस। ओके, नाउ वी गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट। सो फर्स्ट व्हाट वी डू, वी विल कंसीडर अ स्मॉल एरिया एलिमेंट, एरिया वेक्टर dA, ऑफ कोर्स द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज E,
एंड थीटा विल बी द एंगल बिटवीन द
इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड
एरिया B। देयरफॉर फ्लक्स थ्रू द एलिमेंट flux through the element
dA. How much it will be? Of course, d phi E equal to,
what is the definition of flux?
E vector E dot dA.
Correct? Getting my point?
Okay. Therefore, total flux will be phi E, which will be integration of closed surface d phi. Agar d phi ko integrate kiya over closed surface, okay, this side ko bolte hai integration over closed area, integration
dikh raha hai nahi dikh raha
sign dikh raha hai, integration ka sign nikalne ka and one small dot.
Okay,
ऐसा दिखा लो, ये बढ़िया integration का sign, ये ऐसा round बना दिया, हाँ, ये इसको close हो, over a closed, over closed surface.
There are three type of integral. One is called as line integral, second is called as surface integral, and third is called as volume integral. वो भी आप साथ में लिखे रखिए, ये बात में बताता हूँ आपको, मेरे इंट्रोडक्शन पूरा करते हैं उसके बाद में आपको तीन टाइम लिख के देता हूँ। इज दैट क्लियर? तो डी फाई क्या बन जाएगा, डी फाई तो है आपके पास, वो दिया है।
सो फ्लक्स कितना लिखेंगे, फाई ई इंटीग्रेशन और क्लोज सरफेस ई डॉट, ये मिल गया इक्वेशन नंबर टू। तो ना काम हो गया,
हाँ, और वर्क इज ओवर।
वी हैव व्हाट, फाई ई टू इक्वल टू
cube enclosed upon its number. We have got phi e equal to integration of closed surface e dot d. Now LHS of both are same. So if I liquidate RHS, then I will get e dot d integration. That will be equal to this, and this is my Gauss theorem. Okay. So this is the statement of the Gauss theorem. I can take one this, and by comparing these two, I can get the Gauss theorem. So what I suggest you, first of all, to note this down, and then we'll go for again making proper arrangement of that, and lastly what we will get, that we will do, because for the applications we will in the need of that. Okay, I will suggest you to note this down, and then we'll go further. Okay, let's go further. Okay. Expressions I will show.
First we do phi e to be equal to, now I will take q total, that's why q and close capital I do upon epsilon naught. This is my equation number 1. After that I have considered element dA. Okay, flux through element will be d phi, that will be e dot dA.
So second I have taken d phi, that is flux through the element,
that will be called as flux through the element. So repeatedly I am writing these because you will have repeated practice.
Try to get the lead of that.
D phi e, e dot dA, it's all. And then I will go for total phi e, of course, that will be integration for closed surface e dot dA. Because,
okay, I will go one step more. How you wrote it? Like that, also, students are there.
Okay,
it is like five fingers on the hand. All may not be having the same thinking power. Okay, so for all students, I am there.
Okay, so integration of this will be fine. This is what this. So I can write. Phi e equals integration of closed surface e dot dA. Okay. Then this is 1, this is 2. So the LHS of 1 and 2 are same.
So equating LHS of this is again I have written. No need to write for you. This is for your understanding. Collecting what we did mathematics for that. You may continue with that and just you may write from here.
Okay. Equating RHS of equation 1 and 2. RHS of equation 1 and 2. What we will get? Integration over closed surface E dot dA equals Q enclosed upon epsilon.
So while applying the Gauss theorem, you can use this thing. So first you have to integrate E dot dA, vector E dot vector dA. So after that,
you will get something. Most of the times they are telling you to find out the electric field. Okay, so as the application of Gauss theorem will come, they will tell you always to find out the electric field through that area. Okay, so you will ask, sir, directly how we can calculate electric field? You can. They will give you the area, means they will give you the shape. Suppose it is a cylinder, it is a sheet, it is a sphere, hollow or solid, shell like that, they will tell. So according to that, you are knowing the area of cylinder. So that you must know. So suppose if it is a cylinder, of radius r and length l or h, whatever. So surface area of the cylinder will be, what it will be? Yes, surface this. Okay, not this one, this. Okay. So what will be that? This is 2 pi r. How many times? L times. So 2 pi r L. Okay. And that will be, of course, only for outer. Okay. And volume will get then area into length. Okay. So that will be pi r square L. Okay. Now suppose there is a sphere of radius r, then it will be 4 pi r square. Correct. So like that you can go for calculating the total area, but not directly. There are some methods. So actually we have to choose some Gaussian surface. After choosing the Gaussian surface, then we have to proceed further. So let me recollect everything. Gauss theorem, what is the statement? For a closed surface of any shape with any number of charges situated at any place, let me repeat, for a closed surface of any shape with any number of charges situated at any place, the total flux coming out of the surface is always equal to the total charge enclosed by surface divided by permittivity of the medium. Simple, short, we can say for any closed surface, the total flux coming out of the surface is always equal to Q upon epsilon, where Q is the total charge enclosed by surface and epsilon naught is the permittivity of the medium. So this is the first mathematical statement directly for the Gauss law. This we have proved for that surface. So first we took the area element dA, for that we first calculated how many are the flux passing through that. Then we took total flux, that is the integration of phi e, d phi e. Here you have to keep in mind, it is a close, integration of closed surface. So then I put the value of this, and then I got same phi e and phi e. So I equated the RHS. And lastly I got very important statement, that is integration for a closed surface. Vector E dot vector D will be charge enclosed upon epsilon naught. So this is very much important for you people. I will suggest you to note this down. Then I will just explain you what is the line integral, surface and volume integral. Okay. So good. Okay. I hope you have clear now. Now we move on that whatever I told you, line integral, surface integral, volume integral. Actually, it is a part of mathematics, but in physics we are regularly using that. So only the rough idea I give you. We are not going to solve the problem at all. It is not that. So at least you must know that. What is that? Okay. So line integral. Line integral, what it means? suppose I just gave you, okay, this line. Okay, so total length is L. Okay, total length is L. Okay. And this is element D. So we are knowing that what my L will come out to be in division DL. That is very simple. Okay. So if you are going over the length, that will be using with like that. Okay. And if I will make it in the form of a loop, then it will come close. Okay, so that's very simple. Then what will be surface integral? Same. If any surface you are taking,
second one, surface integral. So any surface if you are taking,
and small area component of that dA, that total area will be integration of closed surface dA. So starting from this, everything if you do, that will be coming under surface integral. Okay, so volume integral, that will be V integration dA, the same only you will put for surface, you will put that drop, that will be the integration over a closed surface. So I hope you have understood today's lecture. I will suggest you to go through the module repeatedly. I am telling, solve the problems and ask for the doubts, so that I will be able to solve them at the time of problem solving session. Okay. So I am giving you the opportunity to send me some doubts. Means not doubts, whatever the problems you want to get it solved by me. Okay. अच्छा रहेगा आप अगर मेरे को दे देंगे, मेरे लिए भी थोड़ा सा, अरे हाँ अच्छा है, बच्चों ने दिया, किसी एक स्टूडेंट ने दिया था, नाम नहीं ले रहा हूँ, स्टूडेंट को मालूम है, तो वो प्रॉब्लम मैंने ग्रेविटेशन का सॉल्व करके दिया था। तो ऐसे ही अगर इलेक्ट्रोस्टेट में अगर आपको चाहिए प्रॉब्लम बिंदास, एकदम हल्का रखने का दिमाग सर के पास देने का, सर सॉल्व करेंगे, अपन को भी काम रहेगा थोड़ा सा, आपको भी अच्छा है। ओके, थोड़ा हमारे साथ बातचीत करिए बेटा। I'm waiting for your calls, for your message. Okay, you are all good students. लेकिन बात ही नहीं कर रहे अभी, गुस्सा हो क्या मेरे से? इसका तो जवाब दो, आज के लेक्चर का शाम तक जवाब आना चाहिए। हाँ, are you angry on me? नहीं लगता है ऐसा, लेकिन अगर हो तो भी बताओ, ना हो तो भी बताओ। हाँ, I'm waiting for your reply. Okay बेटा, ठीक से पढ़ाई करो, लेक्चर वगैरह देखो। हाँ, ऐसा नहीं है, हम आपके ही लिए हैं। But you maintain your point. Okay. Tomorrow again we will meet in the electrostatics applications of Gauss theorem. Till that, stay home, stay safe, and stay tuned with physics. Happy learning. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. Bye bye.